Okay, so coming to the next topic, that is the types of window. In the earlier session or in the earlier video, we have seen the different presentation style of multiple windows, how we can present if we are having multiple windows on our screen, then how the system will present it in a multiple ways. Okay, the first we have seen is the was the tile presentation style, the second was overlapping, the third was cascading presentation style. Okay, now we'll come to the types of window. Okay, so the types of windows are depend on the situation and the task what we are performing on the system. Okay, the people's task must be structured into the series of window. As we have seen, if we go to the Microsoft Excel or Microsoft Word or PowerPoint, so if we click on the format or we click on the paragraph option, then a single window will open, another one more window will open. Okay, the window what we have, that is MS PowerPoint or Excel or Word, that is the primary window. Okay, and the second window, that is the paragraph window what we have opened, we have not opened, we have clicked on the option, so that window has automatically opened, so that window is the secondary window. Okay, so basically we are having two types of window. One is the primary window, second is the secondary window. Okay, and both the windows are having different usage, the different guidelines and different tasks. Okay, so the primary window is the main window, we can say a parent window. The secondary window will be called as the child window. Okay, the primary window is not depend on any other window, but the secondary window may not be depend on the primary window. We'll see in the later one. Okay, let us see the first type of the window, that is primary window. Okay, it's a proper usage. It is used to represent an independent function or application. Okay, so if there's an application like function like a paragraph, or if you want to number the point. Okay, so numbering or a paragraph or list or a line spacing or formatting, any other option, so these are the independent function. Okay, so if we click on that particular option, then it will open another window. Okay, so that any function or independent function or application can be used to represent the primary window. It is also used to present constantly used window component and control, that is menu bar items that are frequently used by most or all primary or secondary windows, like formatting or any other option, whatever options which are available in the menu bar. So those all the options are available in the primary window only. Okay, so we have to present all these options in the primary window only, because they are used frequently, they are used primarily by all the users. Second is a control used by the dependent windows. Okay, so the basically your the child window are dependent on the primary window, so your primary window are going to be used proper for that. Use of presenting information that is continually updated, such as date and time. Okay, if any window is the one who is presenting some information that is continually updating. Okay, example is date and time. Okay, so it is the primary window. We have to use the primary window for these kind of works. Okay, second, use of providing context for dependent windows to be created. Okay, and the next is, do not divide an independent function into two or more primary windows. Okay, so these are the 2 points we don't have to do, that is we don't have to divide an independent function into two or more primary windows and present unrelated function in one primary window. So whatever information which are grouped together can be presented in a single window. Its explanation: the primary window is the first one that appears on a screen when activity or action is starting. Okay, so whenever you open any application, for example, if you click on the MS PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint, then what will be the first screen? The MS PowerPoint is the primary window which is coming first. Okay, so that will become the primary window. It is required for every function or application, processing a menu bar and some basic action controls. It has also been variously referred to as the application window or the main window. Okay, sometimes it is also called as, in addition, it is also referred as a parent window. If one or more child window exists, then we can call it as a parent window. The primary window is the main focal point of the user's activities and should represent an independent function. Okay, so the functions and the options which are available on the primary window will not depend on any other one. Okay, they are independent window. It can also be called as the window which is having independent function in it. The example and the image you can see on the screen, that is the primary window. The Microsoft Word, we have opened a Microsoft Word. Okay, so it will act as a primary window. And all the option which are file, edit, view, insert, format, tools, table, window, help. Okay, so if you click on these option, then it will open another window. Okay, so that will become the secondary window, but right now this is the primary window. So independent function should begin in a primary window. Okay, and primary window should contain constantly used window components such as frequently used menu bar items, control, status bar. Okay, all these are the options, or we can say component, which are there in the primary window itself. Okay, so the primary window is the initiator window. Okay, the parent window. Okay, it is the independent window. Okay, so all these words can be used to express the primary window. So this is the first type of window called as the primary window. Second is the secondary window. Secondary window can be used for performing subordinate supplemental action that are extended or more complex in nature. Okay, related to objects in the primary window. For example, we have some statement, some word, text is there. Okay, so if you want to change the size of the text, if you want to change the color of the text, if you want to change the background of that particular text. Okay, so for doing all these, which are quite complex in nature, so for doing all these tasks, we can use the color option available in the primary window. If you click on the color option in the primary window, then it will open another window. It will open another window in that particular, and that window will be called as the secondary window, and that secondary window will contain the options to change the text size, change the text color, change the text style and all that. Okay, to change the background and all that, all the option will be available in the secondary window. Okay, so, and it is also related to objects in the primary window. So for presenting frequently or occasionally used window component also. So we can use our secondary window for these two reasons. Some guidelines. It should typically not appear as an entry on the taskbar. Okay. So basically the saying is that secondary window should not act as a primary window. Okay. Because the primary window is the one who is the initiator of the activity, and the secondary window is the one who will help or who will support the primary window. Okay. Secondary window should not be larger than 263 dialog units by 263 dialog units. So you can say this is the size of any secondary window. Some explanation of the secondary window. They are supplemental window, and secondary windows may be dependent upon a primary window. It may be dependent on a primary window or displayed independently of the primary window. As I told you earlier that secondary windows are dependent secondary window and they are independent secondary window. The dependent secondary windows are the one which is of the very common type. It can only be displayed from a from a command on the interface or its primary window. Okay, so the dependent secondary window, which is depend on the primary window. Okay, the second one is the independent secondary window, which can be open independently of a primary window, which is not depend on a primary window. Okay, you are a dependent secondary window, the first type. The dependent secondary window, it can be displayed from a command on the interface or its primary window. It is typically associated with a single data object and appear on top of the active window when requested. Okay, it is movable and it is scrollable. The independent secondary window, which is not depend on the primary window, it can be typically closed without regards to the state of the primary window. Whether the primary window is closed first, because in case of the dependent secondary window, until and unless we close the primary window, your secondary window cannot be closed. But in independent secondary window, the window can be closed. The independent secondary window can be closed if the primary window is still open. Okay, so this is some part of the explanation, that is secondary window and its two type, that is dependent secondary window and independent secondary window. The dependent secondary window, this is the dependent secondary window and the independent secondary window. You can see the diagram, the tabs, you will find there is no scroll bar, there is no, you can say, maximize button, minimize button, only close button is there. Okay, and this is for the alignment, for the ladder, and some few options are available. This is the secondary window, the example of the secondary window. So we have learned and we have done the two types of window, that is primary window and secondary window. Primary window is the one who is the initiator, who is the parent window of all the windows. Okay, and the secondary window are having two type. Secondary window is the dependent secondary window and the second one is independent secondary window. Dependent secondary window is depend on the primary window, and the independent secondary window is the type which in which it is not depend on the primary window. Okay, so it's all about the type of windows. Thank you so much.